a revised edition of the International Air Transport Association's Dangerous Goods Regulations, or IATA DGR, enters into effect on January 1, 2025. The 2025 edition of the DGR includes many significant changes, including several that affect lithium battery shipments of various kinds. Let's just get right into it. The DGR now lists two UN numbers for lithium battery-powered vehicles, one for vehicles powered by lithium-ion batteries, and one for those powered by lithium metal batteries. Also, there is a new exception for lithium batteries installed in data loggers or cargo tracking devices for 2025. If you use any of the IATA DGR special provisions listed here, you'll want to double check those when you get your hands on a copy of the 2025 DGR, because IATA has updated or revised each of these in some way, shape, or form. To accommodate the addition of those sodium batteries to the DG list, this marking you see on the screen here will no longer be referred to as the lithium battery mark in IATA's regulations. Now, it's simply the battery mark. One more important note for shippers of lithium batteries by air. As of January 1st, IATA recommends that lithium batteries be shipped at no more than 30% state of charge, even when offered in equipment, with equipment, or in vehicles. A mandatory limit on state of charge applies only to batteries shipped alone by air. However, in 2026, a limit on state of charge will become mandatory for some shipments of lithium-ion batteries packed with equipment and for some lithium battery-powered vehicles. For specifics about that, check out the blog post linked above or below this video. That covers a lot of what's new in the IATA Dangerous Goods Regulations for shippers as we look forward to 2025, but it's not everything. If you want to know more, or you need hazmat training required every 2 years by the IATA DGR and every 3 years by USDOT, Lion's final hazmat workshops and webinars of the year are coming up fast. Join us in person, attend a live webinar, or try a self-paced online course for DOT, IATA, or IMDG training. Staying ahead of new and changing U.S. and international regulations is crucial to keep your shipments moving without interruption and to avoid civil penalties that currently max out around $100,000 per day per violation. Thanks for sticking with me to the end of this video. I'll see you in the next one.